Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today I'm working on a severely damaged SD card made by Transcend. It's an older card, but nonetheless it was mailed in, and if we look at it underneath the microscope, it's fairly easy to see the extent of the damage. It's pretty obvious. So we have almost an entire side, actually the entire side, completely lifted off the board. With some potential trace damage going further out. So the best thing to do in cases like this is to remove chips and inspect the surface to see whether or not this card's printed circuit board can be revived, or if it makes more sense just to dump it and recover data directly off the memory chips. These are Samsung branded NANDs. I don't know how well or how bad they will read without attempting to do that. So first, let's assess the board and see how much work is really involved. To remove these chips, I'm gonna use this alloy mix. Alright, so I can tell that there's a lot of them that are missing, but not all of them are connected, and not all of them need to be reconnected. So let's have a look at what we really need to do. On this side, we don't have to do any of them. Actually, no, we do. We need this one, and possibly that one. But that's fairly easy. We'll redo these two. On this side, however, we got 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 pads there, and 14 there. So we got 14 signals on this side. We got one signal on this side. So 15 signals in total to redo. Is it something to that's worth investing time into versus getting it done through the chip off? I'm gonna say it's gonna be fairly equal. No, probably repair will take less, but the benefit of the repair that if it does work, the structure will be perfect. If this memory card has videos, recovering them through repair will be the best way out. Let's see what is the controller on it. So the controller on there is Silicon Motion EN2683B, an older controller. We don't know that the controller is attached or not. So let's troubleshoot the board first and see if it's working. And if it's not working, we're gonna probably dump the idea. I'll check my inventory as well to see if I have better suited donors for it. I don't mind repairing it really. If I have a donor, obviously it will be much quicker. I don't mind investing 20-30 minutes into this repair to make it happen. So if we connect this device through PC3000, and if we get some sort of recognition from the controller, then it would be safe to assume that the board is healthy, and we just need to redo the connections manually, and everything will be back to working state. So when we hook this up through the card adapter. Get this here, and the card adapter was just here as well. There. So we're just sticking in a bare bones PCB. Controller test. SD card adapter is going to be chosen. Dump it into a file mix. Apply. All right, so if we power this up and it gives us a recognition, and it does, SMI right there. So we get 1 gig recognized. The card is fine. The board is good. And these are grounds. Power. And another ground. This side is almost all good. Power and ground. And those are all good. So now,
what
we need to do is set this curing light up. So there we go. We're just gonna set it up and wait until it's done. It's gonna take a while. So it's not a really powerful light, but it doesn't need a battery. So I'm gonna let it hang here for a few minutes and come back when it's ready. It's set. Let's have a look. Oh yeah, it's solid. The bottom chip, because how many pads it lost, they're all still attached to the headers, and that needs to be cleaned up. You can see here, not only that, but the headers are also bent, so okay. Okay, I think that is good enough. Thank you. Okay, this is it. I think we're as good as it can get. I'm just gonna double check the signals to make sure those that have pads, they are not moving. That one might need. Oh no, these are not connected, so, and this one has a wire. holding. These are all wired up. This needs work. See, power up, 15 gigs, project mounts. I'm going to open up a brand new task with PC3000 portable to clone it, and we'll see how well it does. So we're gonna open up USB. No, actually, we're gonna open up no channels. We're just gonna use interface of the tool. So if we're not selecting any ports, we can select whatever other device is already connected. So go into data extractor, and I'm gonna start the task. 7957 clone. And here we will pick Transcend, this device here. Make copy, virtual disk is going to be our target. Let's see. So we got 15 gigs accessible. If we go into sector edit, let's see. First sector is accessible, 55BB. Perfect. We read it up. Pause it. Let's see what's going on. There's the partition. Let's go used sector map. It's full. Great. Now I'm just gonna scan it. We'll go ahead and scan it. Let's pull up this graph side by side. 7 megabytes per second speed, pretty good. So it says it's gonna take about half an hour to clone it all out. The speed is consistent. The job is done, guys. Thank you very much for following this video. Episode was really nice. I feel like we did the right thing by trying to repair the device. And yeah, if you have a damaged memory card or any other data storage device for that matter, check the link in the description, and it will take you to our website where you can request our services, and we'll help you out the same way as we did just now. Thanks for watching again. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment on the video. I'm Arkin. I'll see you guys in the next episode.